So that is our last scheduled testifier. Is there anyone in the audience who wishes to testify on House File 717? Please come down to the testifying table. All right, welcome to the committee. Please introduce yourself for the record.
Thank you, Madam Chair. My name is Marcus Harkis. I'm the Executive Director of the Minnesota Campaign for Full Legalization. Excuse me. We're organizing a statewide grassroots campaign to help end prohibition, to establish an adult personal use cannabis industry, to establish home growing rights, and to help repair the victims of these unjust prohibition laws. I'm also a consumer, and I smoked some nice high grade, high potency cannabis this morning, and I'm still alive. I just have a series of questions I'd like to ask the committee, and I am in favor of this task force. We represent over 500,000 adult Minnesotan consumers in the state of Minnesota. So this is a matter of life and death for a lot of people. Here's the first question. Do you know that marijuana prohibition is based on political corruption, pseudoscience, racism, and for-profit policing? Did you know that cannabis is a healing plant with scores of therapeutic health benefits and not a dangerous killer drug? And unlike opiates, alcohol, and other drugs, legal and illegal, cannabis has no lethal dose, that cannabis is not highly addictive, as drug addiction science has proven less than 10% of consumers get addicted? Did you know that cannabis is ironically a life-saving exit drug for countless people, not a so-called gateway drug, because most cannabis consumers do not go on to try harder drugs, and most consumers don't even continue the habit? Did you know that prohibition has failed to eliminate the illicit cannabis market, which now serves more than 500,000 adult consumers in Minnesota? Did you know that there are more than 500,000 of us that are living in fear of being criminalized and potentially losing everything over this healing plant? And it just makes us feel better. It's never killed a human being in the thousands of years of known human use. Do you agree that we should not be wasting tens of millions of dollars annually in law enforcement resources to arrest and harass thousands of Minnesotans over cannabis? Do you know that the most dangerous thing about cannabis is getting caught with it by the police, because you could lose your freedom, lose your job, lose your property, have your property seized even without being convicted? You can lose your housing and your children. Do you understand, or do you agree, that full legalization is about human rights, not about cannabis consumers having fun getting high? Although that shouldn't be illegal if we're not harming anyone. Cannabis is a healing plant, it's not a crime. I'm almost done. Do you know that thousands of lives are ruined annually because of prohibition, and the longer that we push this down the road, we're gonna have nearly 10,000 people arrested every year? Do you agree that if one truly loves justice, you must hate cannabis prohibition, because it's senseless, it's expensive, it's corrupt, it's structurally racist, and it's failed? Last question, do you understand that there's not one good reason to justify prohibition, but the imperatives of full legalization include respecting personal freedom, increasing public safety, improving public health, and creating economic development statewide? So I'm glad that the initial draft of this bill was amended to include people that are most affected. I am in favor of forming this task force if the people who are most affected are at the table. So I appreciate the amendment that was made, and I support this bill. I just want to close by saying that I'd like to quote Carl Sagan. The illegality of cannabis is an outrageous, it's an impediment to the full utilization of a drug which helps produce the serenity and insight, the sensitivity and fellowship so desperately needed in this increasingly mad and dangerous world. So I just want to let y'all know that prohibition is the problem, it's not cannabis, and that full legalization is the only solution. And that if you include us at the table, we have some expertise, because we've been studying this. So thank you for your attention, and please vote to pass this bill. And thank you for introducing it.
Thank you so much for your testimony.
Thank you, ma'am.